Welcome back, and in this first of two lessons of this mini-series, we're going to step through a simulated exam question, so one which is similar to those that you might experience in the exam. I want you to get comfortable with how I approach questions and how I select answers. One of the things which most students struggle with in the exam is time, so the quicker that we can get through a given question with the correct answer, the better. So let's jump in and get started straight away. Now, as I mentioned earlier in the course, you can approach exam questions in two different ways. You can read the answer first, or you can read the question first. Now, both of these have their pros and cons, and I want you to understand the benefits and negatives of both ways. So let's start with the first question. The first question is that a categram.io lambda function creates a connection to a database and downloads some assets when executed. You notice that your costs for the lambda function are excessive because every invocation is using 1 second to perform this connection and download. What options do you have to reduce costs and improve execution time? And you're told to choose two. Now, in terms of the question length, this is pretty average for an associate level exam. Some are longer and others shorter. If you're using the question first approach, then step number one is to quickly read the question and then perform keyword identification. You're looking for those words which you think matter and those which don't. Every question has a different structure, and so part of this process comes with practice. Now, what we're looking for are the parts of the question which materially impact which answers we're going to select. And this is a process which, as I mentioned a second ago, comes with practice. So why don't you go ahead and pause the video and see which keywords you can identify in this question, and once you're finished, unpause the video and we can compare what I found and what you found. Okay, so at this point, let's have a look at what I found in the question. I've highlighted my main points in red, and for anyone with colour vision deficiency, I've also underlined them. Now, what jumps out at me is that there is a connection to a database, and there is a download of some assets, and there's the fact that both of these are occurring every time the function is executed, which is adding 1 second onto every function execution. So at this point, we have an idea on what the question is asking us and what the key points of the question are. So let's move on and have a look at the answers that we have available. In this case, we have a total of 7 answers. Now, this might initially look intimidating, but there are ways that we can reduce the amount of information that we need to process. First, we can quickly scan the answers and identify anything which can be removed immediately. Sometimes answers self-eliminate. Either they make no sense in isolation, so the answer text is invalid, or they are obviously not related to the specific question scenario. So let's step through them one by one. Well, the top answer immediately jumps out because you can't change the runtime of an existing function. Without considering anything else, this one self-excludes. It eliminates itself because it can never be correct. The second one is an example of something I see in many exams, where there's an answer which seems plausible, but it doesn't fix the root cause, and you need to be careful of these answers. So in this particular case, it's telling us to use a Lambda savings plan. So while a savings plan does in theory offer cost savings, it doesn't in this case fix the root cause, and there isn't actually such a thing as a Lambda savings plan, so you need to pay attention to the detail in every answer. In addition to this, the last answer also self-eliminates, because this is the inverse of what Lambda is as a product. Lambda environments are ephemeral. You can't force them to be persistent, and so we can exclude this answer as well. Now, this leaves us with only 4 possible answers from 7, and we haven't even evaluated these against the question. In this case, 3 out of the 7 answers have self-eliminated. completed. This offers much better odds and much less time processing the remaining answers against the question. Now notice how much of the wording of the remaining answers is the same. Two answers focus on the location for assets, and two answers focus on where to connect to the database. So let's review both of those. So what I've done is separated these two different groupings of answers, and I've highlighted the key parts of each answer. So the top two answers say to store the assets in either the /TMP folder or the assets in the /. So otherwise these two answers are the same. They're essentially just giving you two alternative places to store the assets. And the same is true for the bottom two answers. Both of these say connect to the database, and then one answer is within the function handler and the other is outside of the function handler. Now this is an example of answers which have groupings which are mutually exclusive. Essentially for both of these cases, you're going to pick one or the other. You generally won't be storing assets in both the temp folder and the /. Folder, so you have to pick one of them. And generally you won't be connecting to a database both within the function handler and outside of it, so you have to pick one or the other. Now the way that Lambda works is that any files which you download are stored within the execution environment. Now I talked about in the Lambda in depth sections of the course how there are some efficiencies which can be gained by taking advantage of repeated function executions within the same environment. So this is the difference between a cold start and a warm start. In this example, if we download the assets to the /TMP folder, then if we have any additional warm starts within that same execution environment, then they can use the same assets. We can't rely on this, so we need to check if the assets are located in that folder. If they are, we can reuse them, and if they're not, we have to download them. But this is a way that we can reduce the execution time by doing that check and taking advantage of any warm starts. In addition, in the Lambda section of the course, I also talked about how you can make database connections outside of the function handler. And this means that those connections can be reused for any additional executions within that same execution environment. So again, you're taking advantage of any additional warm starts, so executions which occur within that same execution environment, and you're using the same database connection. So when you want to do this, you need to connect outside of the function handler, because anything within the function handler, that has to be redone every time the function is executed. For anything outside of the function handler, that can potentially be reused. Now again, you can't assume that, so you do have to check that that connection exists, but if it does exist, you don't have to remake that connection. So these are two ways that you can reduce the execution time of your Lambda function. Now all I've done is follow a pretty standard process: keyword analysis on the question, then a quick answer evaluation looking for any which can be self-eliminated. Once any self-eliminated answers are removed, then we evaluate the remaining ones and try to identify any word fluff or any common aspects. In this case, we're able to identify two blocks of mutually exclusive answers, which means that we only have to pick the one correct answer in each block. And so we've massively reduced the amount of processing time and potential for error when answering this question. So I hope that makes sense. This is just the type of process which I step through when I'm attempting exam questions, and this is just one example. In the lesson which is coming up next, we're going to step through another simulated exam question. We're going to follow the same process and look at how we can make the process more efficient and answer each question faster, giving us more time to answer all of the questions in the exam. At this point though, that's everything I wanted to cover, so go ahead and complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.